Hi, I'm Misha, Mikhail Starchenko, and I'm starting a totally free basic course of watercolor techniques that I decided to do free for each person who want to try watercolor can reach this course and to get a proper instructions how to do it. This will cover only basic techniques it's most of the techniques that used in watercolor, and mix of the techniques can make you great artist with very huge arsenal of tools. So welcome. And let's start our first exercise. And our first exercise would be the wash. It's alpha and omega of watercolor techniques. It's most important tool in your weaponry as an artist, as watercolor artist. You cannot be a good watercolorist if you can't handle a wash properly. So this, as I said, most important lessons of the whole course. So please pay attention to each word that I will say and with everything that I will show, because properly handling a wash is as well as important, is it's also quite critical to all other aspects of your watercolor painting. So welcome, and let's start exercise. What we will need on the first exercise? Of course, first thing we need is a paper. I use cotton paper because I believe that paper is most critical element of watercolor painting. It's a base. So it's important to do even such exercises to get it done properly on the good paper. I strongly recommend you to use at least 300 grams on square meter cotton paper for these exercises. If you can afford an arch, that would be perfect. Also, what we will need today is the brush. This is a big one from AliExpress. It's some brand. I cannot even read now. But it says 10, but look at the 10 of Escoda brushes. It's quite big for 10. I don't mind the number of this brush. Just do understand what size is it. The bigger the brush for the wash, the better. I use synthetic brush because of the I don't like hair on my artwork, and I even scared by the hair of my cat that living with me at my house, so I don't want it more from my brushes, so I use synthetic brushes only. Also, we will need a palette, a proper empty space for making our color. Enough mix of paint and water to do the whole exercise. And of course we will need some watercolor paint. This is my palette. It's old Daniel Smith palette. This is the colors of my palette. This is my working colors for this year, and we will use today Taylor Blue green shade. You can use any other color if you want. I just suggest that you will use somewhat blue color for it, because it just make washes much better than, say, any gray granulating colors or earth colors. Just I suggest that you will use non-granulating bluish style of color for our exercise. But you can use any, anyways. And the first thing that I forgot to do in Russian version is I am doing right now simple line drawing for our first exercise. It contains three rectangles and four circles. Just quite easy to do line drawing. You don't have to be very precise. You just have to follow for something similar to what I'm doing here. Just do for it to look as close to it as you can. Now, after we're done with line drawing, let's prepare our paint, our mix of water and watercolor paint. I take my big palette for mixing color. That can hold a lot of water for the wash, as well as some paint. I use Daniel Smith Taylor Blue Green Shade paint for that exercise. You can do almost the same. You can do any paint, but critical rule is for this paint not to be granulating color.
Because we want a clean wash with consistent color all over our wash. And I just, that's just my tip, to use some sort of bluish colors, because I like how do they work on big washes much better than other colors. So that's why I chose my phthalo blue. Why I use phthalo blue green shade, that's quite simple. It's one of my favorite colors on Daniel Smith palette, and it's one of my overall favorite blue colors in watercolor. And the first thing I have to, before applying the color I mixed, I have to test it on some useless piece of paper before I apply on my current paper this wash. So I'm trying this on this piece of paper and see that it's work quite well. And now most important thing, how we do apply the wash. Before I start, I have to say that in Russian language there are two names for this operation with watercolor. One is almost the same as English word wash, and another one is much closer to how to do it, really. It's something like fill up. Because when we do the wash, proper wash, we have to try to touch paper as, avoid touching paper as much as possible. We barely touch the paper with our brush. We just making a drop of the paint, and it's a slanted surface. You have always to do the washes on slightly slanted surface between 20-30 degrees to horizon. So gravity will do the work for us when we're doing the wash. We just starting and doing very light touches, and always keep that water bubble on the bottom as a bubble of water. When you going out of that bubble amount of paint, just wet your brush again, because we moving that bubble of or drop, big drop on the bottom of our wash from up to down. So that's it, that's the way it works under gravity. We just try not destroy the surface of our paper, very lightly fill it up with our paint mix. And that's very important, because I see a lot of not only novice painters, but as well there are a lot of quite experienced watercolorists do not do the wash properly. And that's important to understand how to do it and how to do it as perfect as you can. Please look how I do it and try to do it the same way from the top to the bottom. Don't scrub your paper with your brush. Don't do it. Just don't destroy it. Just try to avoid to touch it as much as possible when you are doing the wash. Please notice how gentle I am with my paper when I'm doing the wash. And of course, try to do the same. This method you can do quite large. It depends on the size of your brush and the surface, but you can do quite large washes all over the big sheets, almost perfect tonally and with the color of the surface you are doing. Just try to do it perfectly, and you will see that you will improve your results dramatically. The first wash I did, I did it without pre-cleaning, pre-wet the surface. So it's gone quite messy by my standards. You see, it's even though I didn't scrub a lot the surface of the paper, it's still slightly unperfect. So next ones we will do with pre-wetted paper. This wetting of our paper have two reasons: to clean it up from any sizing or surface issues, maybe grease, just to clean it up and wet up our surface so it will run in next steps much more perfect. I always recommend to pre-wet your surface before a wash. So now we will do wet all our other line drawings, and we'll do the wash on pre-wetted surface. Also, what I wanna say about this exercise, that for me it's a quite unusual situation, because I really work usually with stretched paper that is already pre-wetted, pre-washed, pre-cleaned with clean water when I stretch the paper. I have to wet it as hell and just to staple it to the board, and when it's dry, it's ready for the work. So just that way I avoid any issues with grease or something on the paper, as well as sometimes I pre-wet it again when I'm doing after line drawing, after a few weeks of work with watercolor. I prefer to clean up the surface before I work on it. I use usually and about the water, I use usually filtered and boiled water. You can use distilled water or do the same as I do. And there are very important thing about water in watercolor, that quality of the water matters. It really matters, and it really matters a lot. Because when you use tap water, it has a lot of chemicals in it and all that stuff, and it's quite unpredictable. It can change the chemicals in your paints and give some unpredictable results in acting in paint acting on the surface. So the cleaner water you use, the more predictable result you have. So this is important. Use as clean water as you can for the watercolor. So now we take our paint mix again and start to do a wash. The same way as we did before, but now we have much better surface to work on. And you see, now I use the same principles, I try to not to avoid touching the paper as much as possible. You can apply wash in a few ways. Most usable ones are with horizontal lines and with light diagonal strokes, step by step. There are two. Say, for example, in Russia, there are one of that type of applying is called more painter's way, and another one called architectural way of applying watercolor in wash. I really don't know which one is better. I do it depending on the situation in my painting. Say, for example, it depends on which way to go, how which way is easier for me when I'm doing that, as well as which way my hand act, even which angle it is in that place above the paper, and there are too many factors to say that this is the proper way and this is not. Just try both of them and use which works better for you. And once again, I remind you, you always have to keep the bubble of paint mix on the bottom when you are doing the wash. That's really important, because if you run out of that bubble and you are doing more complicated washes with a few places to switch between, it just can suck and dry on the paper, and you will never remove the border of your previous run So you will not have continuous perfect wash if you will not keep the bubble. Just defend the wetness of the bottom of your wash from drying. So that's the way how it works. Keep that in mind. It's really important to use the bubble of paint on the bottom of your wash. And you see, the second wash is way more perfect than previous one. That's because we worked on a pre-wetted surface, and that's important to try to do it as much as you can, as much as possible, to use pre-wetting the paper when you are doing the wash. I have to remind that this is most important basic technique used in watercolor, and even there are some artists that use only a lot of washes or overlapping each other, many layered washes to do their paintings, and it's nothing wrong with that because it's, I'd call it, most powerful technique that is the core of watercolor painting. Sometimes when I'm too lazy to wash my brush and to lose my paint mix, I use a paper towel to absorb too much bubble at the end of the wash. So it's quite usable. You always have to keep some paper towels on your working area when you work with watercolor. It's a must-have tool on your working area. And it must be as close to your painting as possible, always, when you work. And here is slightly more complicated wash. This donut we have to draw. Now we have to wash it, fill it with wash, with our paint. And here we, for the first time, we are going to split bubbles. So we start. And then we have bubble on the left and bubble on the right. And we have to work with them step by step, always keeping a bubble on the bottom of each section. We are going left, we are going right, we are going left again, more progression. Then we back to right. That's the way how it works. Then we connect both splitted sections and continue with our wash. That's it. We will have more complicated exercise, special for these splitted washes, more advanced washes in next exercises. Just keep in mind, this is the first time you do it, that this is the way how to do it. And now we remove unnecessary bubble when we finished with our wash. We remove unnecessary amount of paint from the bottom, because if we leave it, it will dry and do some weird things, because watercolor works that way. Now it when it's it has very thin layer of paint, it dries and the bubble is not really, and we will have on the border of wet and dry surface, we will have a lot of artifacts that we don't want to have. Always just dry the bottom bubble when you finished with your wash. And now we start our last steps. We are doing the second layer wash over previous layer. This is how multi-layer painting works. You can use it to make more color and tone to it. You can use different colors, for example, say you can mix yellow, completely yellow wash with blue wash, and you will have a beautiful green wash overall. So they mix up very well. Just keep in mind that you have to wait for the previous layer of your wash to dry completely. It must not be wet. Dry it completely. Some people use hair dryers for drying out the watercolor paintings, but I would not recommend it. I try to avoid it as much as I can after discussing this with John Cogley, Daniel Smith, CEO and owner. That he said me that it can change really the if it's too hot from hair dryer, it can change chemical formula for some ingredients in painting, some pigments. So it's non 100% proof that it's that there will be changes. So I try to avoid hair dryer as possible and keep my paintings to dry completely natural. And just that's just it. You have to live with it. That's my tip on hair drying. So multi-layer washes, you have always wait for the previous washes to dry completely. You have to start on completely dry surface, because if you are not, you probably can lift up some paint, it's and some artifacts as well that will be seen, and you will lose your perfect wash, previous wash and new wash. You will lose the perfection of the surface. Just wait for it to dry completely.
So this is the final result up close, and you see that non-washed with clean water part has some imperfections in it because of the brush stroke and surface. And you see that other one that was watered before I applied the wash, it's more predictable and almost perfect. Maybe some edges, but that's because I work not as I feel comfortable with when I working for the video, because I work almost like this when I do my own paintings. So when it start for the camera with some distance, I do much worse with edges and all that stuff, because even I see it much less perfect. But you see, at least the wash is quite nice and smooth when you water down. So this is our first lesson with wash. Most important tool in watercolor. Don't forget to subscribe, and give me a like, and of course, I believe it's stupid, but all bloggers do it in their videos, so I just mimic them. In there. So wait for the next exercise, and we will do more tools. See you. Bye bye.